thinking about you. I'm with you. My thoughts and prayers are with you and your family.
Just want to wish you guys a congratulations from the bottom of my heart.
Tom Brady sends out messages for graduations, NFL fans, and draft classes. But it's the notes to individuals.
Hey, Noah.
Like the 1 to 9-year-old Noah Reed that can carry the most weight.
Hang tough. You're going to be great. I know it. And get well soon. Take care.
Noah, from the time he was little, has been very intuitive. He is a kid that you will meet and say, that's an old soul.
I want to see what you look like when you're pumped.
Yeah. Noah approached me one day and he said, Dad, who's the greatest quarterback?
He said it was Tom Brady. So ever since then, I've always just kind of like read books about Tom Brady. I've watched Tom Brady, and then that's made me like him even more.
If only all of his questions could be so easily answered. If only his curiosities could remain so innocent. Nearly a year ago, Noah's life in his home state of Utah would take a dramatic turn.
So in December, he woke me up and said, Mom, my head's killing. I knew something was wrong when the second one hit, almost, because I was like, we just had one. We need to go into the doctor. We need to figure this out.
We were in the doctor's office, and he showed us the picture of the mass in my brain.
And he said, Noah has a brain tumor. And I said, is it like cancer? He goes, yeah, brain cancer.
Me and my mom and dad and Scarlett and Maxine, we were just all in a lot of pain. It still really hurts to think about it, like the fact that I got through it, just unbelievable.
Bye, Noah.
Let's do
See
it.
See you soon, buddy. I'll have steak ready.
Okay. For the weeks to follow, Noah would endure multiple brain surgeries and a craniotomy to ease the pressure on his brain, even before 4 cycles of chemotherapy and then radiation helped shrink the tumor.
I said, hey, son, do you need anything? Are you thirsty? Do you need ice? Do you need another pillow? He kind of nods no, and he says, no. And he says, Dad, I just really need to watch highlight reels of Tom Brady.
So when he spiraled down, he spiraled down. And that wasn't him. That was chemicals in his little body.
Why does it have to be me?
Hey. Because you're one of the strong ones, okay? Okay, just remember that.
One of the darkest days also coincided with a turning point for Noah.
We were sitting in the driveway, Noah and I, and he was starting to spiral. In the midst of all that, my phone, I heard it ding, and I'm looking at it, and I'm like, oh my gosh, Noah.
Hey, Noah, how you doing? I just wanted to let you know that I'm thinking about you. I know you're one of my biggest fans in Utah, and I know you got a great family that loves you and support your mom and dad and your siblings, and I just want to let you know I'm thinking about you. I'm with you. My thoughts and prayers are with you and your family. And hang tough. You're going to be great. I know it. And get well soon. Take care. Bye-bye.
And we both start even crying harder, and we're just laughing and crying. I'd always watch that video just, like, to remind me if, like, I mean, Tom Brady thinks I can beat cancer, so, I mean, I guess I can beat cancer.
The treatment continued, and through it, a promise from his parents.
They said, Noah, when you beat brain cancer, we promise we'll take you to see Tom Brady live.
By late summer, the cancer was gone. And so, just 9 days ago, 48 hours before the Bears would play the Bucs, Jackie purchased the best possible seats for father and son on a trip that would take them more than 2,000 miles.
That, dude.
With a sign that captured the hearts of all who saw it. As the game progressed, Noah and his dad were determined to get Brady to notice, with the fans around them rallying to their cause.
I looked up right behind our bench, and I see this kid with the Bucs jersey on, and I see a sign, you know, it said, "Tom Brady helped me beat cancer." So, you know, it'd be real cool. I was like, if I can get time to just wave at him.
Dude, he told Tom.
Chris Godwin had come over and told me, "Hey, you know, behind the bench, you know, there's a little boy, you know, look over." So I kind of caught a glimpse and then saw his dad, and his dad said, "You know, this is Noah, you made a video for him earlier this year," so you know, I didn't know he was actually at the game.
Yeah, I'm like in shock. I like don't really believe it's happening. He sticks the hat on my head, he shakes my hand, and he says something like, "Nice job, buddy."
When I see you, Tom lay that hat on his head, like on his little, right over his scars.
If you could say something to Tom Brady right now, what would you say?
Thank you. I mean, like, that's all I really have to say. Thank you.
Sorry. Thank you.
Sometimes it is just a stupid game that we all love. And sometimes we're reminded of the impact that this game can have on people's real lives. And Noah, you are a hero. We are so happy that you're okay, and to your beautiful, loving family, we just we send all our love. Thanks to Jeff Darlington for sharing that story. We now cry on the show every week.
Keep fighting, Noah.
Way to go.
We are so impressed by you. You know what's cool, though? Noah, today, of course, for Halloween, he has to go as his hero, Tom Brady. How great is that? I hope he gets to go to many more games. Gotta love that. Noah, sending all of our love to you today.
That's cool.
Very cool. Let's head out. Let's get ourselves together and head